Estimations is a little bit of a controversial topic. Why so? The reason is that business people, they need estimation. And dev folks, they absolutely hate estimations. In this video, you will learn what makes estimations so much inaccurate and what you can do about that to make your estimations more accurate. Hi there, my name is Dada Sasha. I'm a self-taught developer with testing background, currently based in the UK. On this channel, we help developers to learn more about testing and test automation, as well as test-driven development, agile and extreme programming. So make sure to like this video and subscribe to this channel. There are going to be even more great videos on those topics.
As always, we have added time codes for your convenience, so you can jump directly to the part of the video you're most interested in.
By the way, do you know how much the estimations are usually off? Closer to the end of the video, I will tell you. So why does business need estimations in the first place? The first reason is that business needs some certainty. Business people operate with numbers. They need to know, ideally exactly, how much they're going to spend on producing a product, as well as when they can expect this to be ready to launch. Taxes, budgeting, marketing, subcontractors, even our users are all require as much certainty as we could provide. In addition to that, if you know how long a particular task would take, you can actually improve a lot your prioritization. For example, if there is something which looks very important but will take ages to do, it may not be the first thing you should be doing. Maybe instead you can do some shorter tasks which look like they're less important, but because they're shorter, you can actually get more value out of them. Last but not least, when there is an estimation, or actually when there is a commitment. The commitment can be very important and effective for negative reinforcements for developers. Essentially, commitment slash estimations make developers want to complete a particular task sooner rather than later. So what is a developer's perspective on estimations? Why do developers hate estimations? And the developer's perspective is actually influenced by business perspective. First of all, developers know that estimations are usually off, they are usually inaccurate, and therefore developers hate giving estimations because they know those estimations are going to be wrong. Having not enough information about the task they're working on, developers realize that whatever estimation they give to you, it would be just a bad guess. And the only way to improve this guess would be to actually complete the task, which is not very helpful. And last but not least, developers know by heart that estimations can and will be forced at the commitment, at least at some point. As you can see, the developers and business perspective on the estimation is somewhat different, yet very much connected. But why estimations are usually so wrong? Many reasons for that. And the first one, probably my favorite one, is that you don't know what you don't know. I can give you a very small example demonstrating that it is very important to remember that you may not have all the information required to make a good estimation. Some time ago, I was filling a forms for my children's school, and it looked like a 20-minute business, so I thought I would be able to complete this by the evening. And on page number 7, I realized that this page number 7 has to be given to the school office. So what I just learned is that there was a big part of the task which not only going to take longer, but also is not done by me. So I actually have no real influence on how long it's going to take. Another example of estimations being extremely off happened during renovation in my office. The original plan was simple, just paint one wall and a little bit of ceiling, and that should be it. 2 hours job. So I did paint the wall and ceiling, and then when taking off the painting tape, I accidentally took off some of the wallpapers. Long story short, not only we now had to take off all the wallpapers, but we had to do quite a bunch of other things, including repainting walls and ceilings. Not only our estimation was wrong, but our understanding of the progress was not correct either. Some of the job had to be redone. And of course, lots of things like that going to happen with our work task. Essentially, there is only one way to learn everything about the task at hand, complete the task. And when you complete the task, the estimation is not very helpful. And of course, in every real team, in addition to your own tasks, there are some environment factors, meeting requests, your team members that may need some help from you, or any other urgent task, which will disrupt any kind of planning that you make. When we make an estimation, Our brain attempts to make a prediction based on the information we know at the moment. In addition to that, our psychology adds additional mistake due to fear of giving too long estimate, because it could be considered as a sign of weakness or unprofessionalism. Going back to the question, what is a typical mistake developers make when providing an estimate? According to some research, it may be as big as 50% between estimated and actual effort. So how do we handle estimation mistakes? Is there a way to handle them at all? There are three main strategies of handling an estimation mistake: corrective factor, 3 points estimation, and agile estimation techniques. Corrective factor approach is based on the fact that, as a rule of thumb, developers would give an optimistic estimation. To tackle the mistake, we would simply multiply provided estimation by a certain corrective factor. Let's say we have estimated that a particular task would take 2 days to complete. If a corrective factor is 50%, our final estimation will be 3 days. The trick is to choose a corrective factor that would statistically be more or less accurate for a particular product, environment, and team. 3 points estimation is based on the idea that estimating is actually predicting a value of a certain function, which usually sticks to normal distribution. To make 3 points estimation, you need to come up with optimistic, pessimistic, and realistic estimate. Then you could just calculate expected estimate using this magic formula. There is actually more than one formula available, but you can just try this one for a start. As you could probably have guessed, all estimation correction approach would still leave some kind of error. So what if we just stop trying to predict the future and instead try to make an educated guess based on the data that we have? First approach to do agile estimations called sizing. People are not very good at measuring things, but actually quite good at comparing them. For example, if you look at those boxes, I can't tell you what size each box is, but I can actually compare them quite fast.
So, we will compare tasks against each other using story points as a measure. Furthermore, by using Fibonacci sequence, we factor in an uncertainty correction. As a last step, by measuring the team velocity, we could make more or less reliable prediction how long a particular task would take.
So these were 4 helpful tips that can help improve your estimation, or at least make you struggle less with estimations. I wanted to ask you, do you use any other way? Maybe there is something that I should have mentioned, but I didn't mention. Please share your experience in comments. I would really love to learn more about this.